for some pressure. So last time I talked about moments of a force, factors affecting moment of force, units of force, application of moment of force. Now today we're going to do a few sums that are in the book, just the examples, but I'm going to explain it. Okay? So moment of a force, M is equal to force, which is F into moment arm T. Okay, so we have done this formula last time. So we're going to do with the examples. The first example on page number 21 states, the hinge of a door is 1 meter. The hinge of a door is 1 meter. So, moment arm. Moment arm, which is usually written as 1 meter, is 1 meter. The hinge of a door is 1 meter from the point of application of force. If a force of 70 Newton, F,
person using a 40 centimeter
long handle spanner can open a nut by applying a force of 120 newton. The force is 120 newton. Okay. What should be the length of the handle if he wants to open the nut by applying a force of? This is force 1. Force 2. What should be the length of the handle if he wants to open the nut by applying a force of 80? Okay. So here force is 120. This is each one. This one, okay. Force is 120 newton. Moment arm is 24 meter. Moment of force m equal to F into d. Moment of force 120 newton into 0.4 meter. Okay. So this comes to 48 newton meter. Okay. So in the second case. Case 2, okay, so case 2 force is 80 newton, moment of arm we have to find out because it says what should be the length of the handle if it wants to open, open the nut by applying the force of 80 newton, okay. Now, case 2 force is 80 newton, okay, but moment of force will be taken as the first one that we got from the first case, we should be 48. That, so the handle of the spanner should be 60 centimeters to open the nut in the force of 80. So that was the sums which have gone through in the exams. You might be doing the sums, whatever exams are coming now. Now the next topic that we talk about is pressure. Okay, so pressure. See, pressure is such a thing which is that even right now atmospheric pressure is being applied on a body. Pressure that is there because of the air, we cannot feel it because the dissolved oxygen in our blood is at a higher level than the pressure of oxygen inside the body is at a higher level than outside, so we cannot feel it. But if that pressure drops, then we can feel the difference. Okay. So, so out here it says there are some activities given to show that the effect of force depends upon the area over which it is applied, materials required, a pencil and a sharpener. Procedure: sharpen the pencil at one end, hold it between the index fingers of both your hands and press it from both sides. On which finger do you make the pencil you see? You take a sharp pencil, pointed end should be this side, and unpointed end, let's say this is the pencil, this is the pointed end this side, and you push it like this. Okay, where will you feel the pressure? Pointed end will feel the pain basically. Okay, because area is less, pressure will be more. Okay. So conclusion, the effect of force is greater when the hand area of contact is smaller. Similarly, when you cut an apple, you will notice that it is easier to cut with a sharp knife where the area is smaller than with a blunt knife where there is obviously the sharp. Why do you sharpen the knife actually? We are reducing the pressure. Because pressure is given by the formula. Pressure is given by the formula. small, pressure will be big. If area is big, pressure will be less.
Understood.
So that's why we sharpen the knife, because we're reducing the area. So when you have to apply minimum force, you can cut easily.
Right.
So that is what this talking about. Activity 2, to show that the effect of force depends upon its magnitude. There are two bricks. Materials require three bricks of the same size and weight and a glass filled tray with soft mud. Procedure: place bricks A and B alongside each other on the soft mud. You will notice that both the bricks will sink to the same level in the mud. True, right? You take two bricks and loose mud, both of them will sink to the same level. Okay, now you add one more brick on one of them. Okay, now observation says you will notice that though the area of contact with the mud is same, brick B sinks deep. Now put brick C on brick B. They are saying just add one more brick onto one of the existing bricks, that will sink more. Okay. Conclusion: the effect of force depends on the magnitude of the force. Greater the force applied, greater the effect.
That's true.
And the said these two are directly proportional to each other. Force is greater, pressure will be greater. Okay. So that's what pressure is all about. Formula I have already given. Okay. So force is thrust. Force is in Newton, area is meter. Okay, so the inertia pressure will be Newton meter. Area will always be square. Okay, so this will be Newton. So it is N. N. And area will always be in meter square. So calculating area, that's it, meter square. So the unit of pressure will be square, which is also called Pascal, which is also written as PA in honor of scientist Blaise Pascal. Okay, so this is what pressure is all about. Please remember, pressure and force are directly proportional, area is proportional. Okay, so force is Newton, and what is saying.